In this video, I'm gonna teach what I look for when I'm looking for snakeheads. I'm gonna show locations in the canal that I think are good for snakeheads. For example, you see those lily pads right there? And you see how there's an open space right here? That's somewhere I would throw if I wanted to catch a snakehead. I'm gonna walk this entire canal and show areas that I like. This is Markham Park. This place is infested with snakeheads. So if you want to catch a snakehead, this is a good place to start. Now I'm going to continue the video, walk around and show places. One thing that snakeheads like is submerged aquatic vegetation, submerged timber next to aquatic vegetation, as you can see right there. That will be an area that I will work with a lure. And if you look on the other side of the bank, you notice that there's lily pads and there's like an open space between the lily pads and the shoreline. I would cast a lure all the way to the end of the shoreline, work there, and then work it back here. So this looks like another good area to fish. If you notice, there's a break where the lily pads are not growing and then they start growing again. This is another good spot to work the lure. So again, there's a piece of submerged timber around aquatic vegetations, around rocks. This is a good spot for snakeheads. You see that tree over there with the overhanging branches? If you can cast far enough, I would throw a lure under that tree on the shoreline, then let the lure fall back in the water and work it back to the shore. That looks like a really good spot for snakeheads. All the information I'm giving in this video can be applied to almost any canal in Broward County, West Palm Beach County, even Miami-Dade County, where bullseye snakeheads can be found. Yeah, this all looks really good for snakeheads. The whole shoreline filled with aquatic vegetation close to the shoreline. One thing to know about snakeheads is that they're very different from bass. Bass, as you know, can be caught almost anywhere in the body water. It can be caught near the shoreline, in deep water. Snakeheads seem to be a little more selective. They like to be near the shore, real close to the shoreline. In fact, one of my favorite ways to catch snakeheads is to work a lure no more than 10 feet away from the shoreline. As you can tell, all this aquatic vegetation is growing no more than 10, 15 feet from the shoreline. A lot of times when you walk around the canal, you will scare the snakeheads way before you get there. So I recommend that when you fish for snakeheads, you walk much slower than I'm walking in this video. This is part one of where to catch snakehead and tips. On the second video, I'm probably gonna show myself catching fish. If you like, look, I just scared something right there. I don't know if you see the wake. May or may not have been a snakehead. So if you like this video and you want to see me catching snakeheads here, let me know. I'll come back and I'll show them catching them. But this canal is completely infested with snakeheads. Oh, and there's also snook here. Pretty big snook, in fact. There are snook in this canal that are overslot. So know that when you're coming here, it's not just bass fishing, snakehead fishing. There's also snook here, tarpon. You'll be surprised what you can catch in these canals. As you can tell, there's a, not sure if you can see it, but there's a spawning radar sunfish there. Bunch of fish are spawning right now because the weather's warm, which is most of the year in South Florida. So you notice that spot right there? This is one of the main things I look for when I'm looking for snakeheads. If you notice, there's a part of the canal where it looks like it connects to the main lake of Markham Park. Right there is a body of water where the snakeheads like to hide. I'm gonna walk to it and discuss more. So this right here is probably one of the best spots you can catch snakeheads in Markham Park. It's an intersection between the main canal and one of the lakes in Markham Park. What I would do is I would walk away about 50 to 100 feet of this spot, cast a little bit past this intersection, maybe 10, 20 feet, work a frog lure real close to shoreline. Real good chance there's snakeheads here. Gonna walk to the lake now. This is a very good spot to fish for snakeheads and bass in Markham Park. It connects to the main canal. As you can tell with the running water, I would fish a hollow belly duck, a hollow belly frog here. Going to the main canal now. One thing when you're fishing Markham Park and many of the canals in South Florida is that you have to worry about alligators. This alligator right here is not that big. It's probably, I will say, 5-6 feet. But as you can tell, this alligator is in Markham Park. So always pay attention to where you fish in Markham Park because there's lots of alligators here. So we're going to the next spot now. Snakeheads love structure. So wherever you see a bridge, a dock, submerged timber, you can expect snakeheads to be there. So we're about to walk to an area, it's like a marina. So I'm going to one of the best fishing spots in Markham Park. This little marina that you see here is a very good spot for snakeheads, bass, peacock bass, tarpon, and snook. Mostly peacock bass, snakeheads, and snook. So you can see some people are gonna go fishing. So you see all this right here? Under that dock is infested with fish. So this is one of my favorite fishing spots in Markham Park. It's right next to a marina. Here I've caught some nice snook, peacock bass, largemouth bass, also good for snakehead. This is another thing I look for snakeheads. Any part where the canal changes the contour of the shoreline. As you can see, the shoreline changes. There's lily pads, access to deep water. I would focus on this spot. So I'm gonna get a closer look to the alligator we saw earlier. Here's another good place to fish for snakeheads and bass in Markham Park. So the reason this is a good spot is because there's trees next to a shoreline with aquatic vegetation growing close to a shoreline. See right here, you want to fish under that tree. Cast to the other end of the shoreline, drop it in the water, work it back. There's a tree more far ahead that's even better. So So I would get around here and I will cast as far as possible to that tree, preferably under that tree. Get as close as possible without scaring the snakeheads. That's all prime snakehead territory right here. Submerged timber, a tree next to a shoreline. Far away from the main park, so there won't be that many people fishing here. Definitely come here if your goal is to catch a snakehead in Markham Park. You see that tree by the fence? You wanna get close enough where you don't scare the snakehead, but close enough where you can cast under that tree, about 3 to 5 feet away from the shoreline, work the frog, and you'll probably get a hit there. All this area that I'm pointing at right now, highly recommend fishing here with zoom horny toad, hollow belly duck, hollow belly frog, spinnerbait, whatever you like fishing with for snakeheads. Me personally, I like the zoom horny toad and hollow belly duck, but you know, you can use what you like. A lot of people have success with swim baits. Yeah, all this is really good. Now the bank is a little steep here, so be careful. See that right there? That is a prime ambush spot for snakeheads. Right under a tree, aquatic vegetation, rocks close to the shoreline. So we're getting to another spot that's really good. See? These bridges are a short walk away from the main park, and one thing that snakeheads like, they like to be in shady areas. And also when it gets to, look, here's another good spot. Definitely fish this area. So we're approaching one of the best spots in the park. I will definitely put in about 10-15 minutes here. See, under that tree right there. Work all this shoreline. If you look into the distance, you're gonna see a big tree. Under that tree is a good ambush spot for snakeheads. Oh yeah, that tree looks real good. So we're over 100 yards away from the main park. Not a lot of people come here, which is good, because that means that less people fish and the snakeheads will be less worried. So this is a good spot if you're willing to walk a little far. So you see that tree right there? Try to cast under that tree. Try to throw like a hollow belly duck, hollow belly frog, zoom horny toad. right there. Cast a frog under that tree around this area. I will spend a good 10 minutes here. Fish all around this tree. As you can see, if you keep going further, there's more spots to fish for snakeheads. More trees by the shoreline, more aquatic vegetation. Under that bridge over there is real good. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video so far. This is mostly an instructional video where I teach where to catch snakeheads at Markham Park, what I look for when I'm looking for snakeheads, and this information can be used in almost any canal you go in South Florida. I'll probably post more videos like this one, and I'm hoping to post part two sometime in the near future. And part two, I'll show myself catching snakeheads. This is another good place to fish for a bullseye snakehead, largemouth bass, peacock bass, snook, tarpon. It's the entrance of Markham Park, where there's a bridge, another man-made structure. Definitely fish under there. Good spot for snook. Snakeheads also like it. And this is a long walk. If you were to walk all the way down here, you'll eventually reach a spillway. That spillway, I'm gonna include a picture on Google Maps to show you where it is, has very good snook fishing. And a lot of people don't know about it. So that's worth going back there. See some people walking back there. Maybe another time I'll show a video back there. But for now, I'm just gonna show this right here. Oh, just scared some fish near the shoreline. Some Maine cichlids. Right now, all the exotics are spawning. So Maine cichlids, Oscars, jaguar pody. You can find them all along the shoreline. Also, snakeheads are spawning now. Yep. Great place to go fishing. I'm gonna walk to the Markham Park sign. This is the other side of the bridge. Very good spot for bass, snakehead, anything that bites here. Especially on days that are very hot, the fish are gonna be under the shade. This is one of the spots you wanna fish. So this is one of the marinas in Markham Park. This is another good spot to go fishing for bullseye snakehead, peacock bass, largemouth bass, snook. You probably see Maine cichlid spawning there. Probably doesn't show up in this video, but this whole shoreline, you see this? fish just jumped over there. I would throw the frog as far as you can, close to the shoreline, and work the frog multiple times. I'll give about a good 10 minutes here, because this is a good spot. If you can cast to the other end. This little cove right here is also very good. Cast the frog as far as you can, all the way to the end to where you see those trees, and work the frog all along the shoreline. Here's a good fishing spot by the campground. So always look for snakes, always look for alligators, because they're everywhere in the Everglades. But right now I don't see them in this particular spot. Very good spot to fish, and you'll be away from people for the most part. So there's a rock right here that you can stand. And yeah, as you can see, there's lily pads, aquatic vegetation. Cast the lure as far as you can and work between the area of the aquatic vegetation and the shoreline. Do that a couple times and throw outside the aquatic vegetation. And this is pretty close to the marina. Thank you.